Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their 107th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 677.
One, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1085, then landed successfully for the third time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 2, terminal guidance.
Stage 1, landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Then yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 108th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 910.
1, ignition. And with Falcon 9, go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1081, then landed successfully for the 11th time on the drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing is confirmed.
Later today and going into next week, we can hopefully expect to see a bunch of launches. The first of these, the Starlink 669 mission, is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 10th at 9:28pm UTC or 4:28pm EST. Then tomorrow we can hopefully expect to see a customer mission launch. The KoreaSat 6A mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 11th at 5:07pm UTC or 12:07pm EST. A couple of days later and we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 668 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 13th at 11am UTC or 6am EST. A little under a day later and we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 911 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 14th at 4:21am UTC or Wednesday 13th at 11:21pm EST. A couple of days after that and we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink launch. The Starlink 666 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 16th at 6:04pm UTC or 1:04pm EST. Finally, we can hopefully expect to see another customer mission launch the following day. The Optus X mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 17th at 9:29pm UTC or 4:29pm EST. I wanted to share an article related to Starlink and a Martian constellation. It says SpaceX is working on a concept version of Starlink for Mars according to a NASA presentation. There was an article posted about SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft raising the orbit of the International Space Station. It says SpaceX's 31st commercial resupply mission lifted off November 4th, launching a Dragon cargo vehicle to rendezvous with the International Space Station, docking to the station's forward-facing port the next day. Today, November 8th, for the first time, Dragon performed an orbit-raising maneuver to stabilize the ISS's trajectory in low Earth orbit. Heading to Boca Chica, work continues on the assembly of the Pad B launch mount. Work has been continuing on the flame trench for the Pad B launch site. Work has also been continuing on the Pad A launch mount as they prep for Flight 6. Some protective boxes were seen being installed around tank farm components. Recently, Starhopper was seen being pressure washed. We could have Starship Flight 6 a lot sooner than we had thought, with some information posted by SpaceX. They said Starship's fifth flight test was a seminal moment in iterating towards a fully and rapidly reusable launch system. Next up, the sixth flight test of Starship is targeted to launch as early as Monday, November 18th. There was a Reddit post with information from a video of Kathy Luders answering questions. It says she was giving presentation at a conference and as part of Q&A she said that if sixth flight goes well, Raptor relight so they can go to orbit on future flights, they are hoping on catching the ship within 6 months. She also said Elon wants to do 25 flights in 2025. Work has been seen going on with the B-14.1 test tank in the rocket garden. Starship 31's heat shield tiles continue to be worked on in the high bay. Starship 31 has recently been seen sporting a banana decal. A Starship 37 LOX header tank was spotted inside Star Factory. A hot staging ring likely for Booster 13 was spotted. Another barrel section for the Booster 16 vehicle was spotted being moved in the yard. To finish up the video today, SpaceX have a bunch of temporary closures scheduled. The closures are for tomorrow, Monday 11th, Tuesday 12th, Wednesday 13th and Thursday 14th. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.